Hello everyone, welcome to Positron Plays Dark Souls 3. Oh dear god, what have I gotten myself into? Let's start a new game here and I'll let the cutscene play and we'll get started.
Yes, indeed. It is called Lothric, where the transitory lands of the Lords of Cinder converge. In venturing north, the pilgrims discover the truth of the old words. The fire fades, and the lords go without thrones. Undead Legion, the Abyss Watchers. And the reclusive lord of the profaned capital. Yon the Giant. Kindled will rise. Nameless, accursed undead, unfit even to be cinder. And so it is that ash seeketh.
Hold on. Alrighty, so I've already made an appearance. Going to play as a badass lady with purple hair, because why not? I will name myself Positron, even though that's not a very ladylike name, just in case that's what shows up for online play and things like that. Burial gift. I'm actually not 100% sure on just yet. Age, young, appearance, voice. I want to make sure it's the mature voice, because the young voice, kind of weird. Class, I'm going to start as a thief, which is, from what I understand, really not recommended, but I'm kind of, you know what, let me check on dexterity here. 14. 16 on the mercenary. Yeah, I usually don't play dexterity, so for a little change of pace, plus I like starting with a bow. I've heard the bows are pretty good now, so I kind of want to play around with that a little bit. But I can always, you know, kind of build a little differently. So I'm thinking either the Sovereign of the Soul seems kind of moot. You can always get souls. Rusted Gold Coin seems pretty good. Fire Gem seems pretty good. The real question is, am I going to use the Rusted Gold Coins? And I kind of get the feeling the answer to that is no. So I think I'm going to go with the Fire Gem. Maybe I can get a Fire Weapon early on. And I think we are set with that. I don't think I'm missing anything else. So yeah, let's get started. I've played all the Souls games. You know, started with Demon Souls and played Dark Souls 1 and Dark Souls 2 and played Bloodborne. Though I never got around to finishing Bloodborne. I got pretty close, damn close to the end, too. I think I have sound at an okay level. Actually, I have dialogue in the game raised up a little bit, too. But I can always adjust that as time goes on here. And I will, of course, note, I am certainly no, why is my shield being held? Why is my shield being held? Alright, I'm very confused by that right now, but, I'm not gonna worry about it for the moment. And we'll just get on going, and I'll fix that. In a moment. But anyway, yeah, so I'm certainly no pro Souls player. So it'll be an interesting experience. Parrying is not my strong suit, which is bad news for a dex character, but I'm okay. I'll probably get the hang of it as time goes on. At least we can all hope so. Now, I haven't played pretty much any of this yet. I played a little bit of this area just to kind of get myself accustomed to the controls again. But for the most part, this is all going to be entirely blind, which, again, maybe not recommended. Thought there was another enemy here, actually. Yeah, so this is going to be an entirely blind playthrough. So, as per usual, please don't give me spoilers. Tips are welcome, but preferably no spoilers. I'm going to attempt to do that a lot. I don't know if I'm going to be using much in the way of magic. I might try to pick something up, but I'm not quite sure how that's going to work build-wise. Typically, I don't go for like super optimal builds. Oops, missed the backstab there. Typically, I don't go for super optimal builds either. I kind of just go with whatever feels right at the time. Oh, hello. So we can actually do a little bit of that ourselves. Although I am not entirely sure. Before I do any more bow stuff, I'm gonna have to make a jump cut in this video and figure out what's going on with my controller. An odd way to start, isn't it? Gotcha. I'm sure these are all tutorial messages. The kick, a little awkward to use. Parry and riposte. Ah, ragdolls. One of my favorite things. Oh. Use weapon skills. So what is my weapon skill here? Seems like a dash of some sort. Uses some stamina. Uses some MP as well, actually. Interestingly enough. Hello, friends. Ooh, missed that one. There we go. The more I can get used to that on easy enemies, the better, that's for sure. Actually, totally whiffed that one, but that's okay. Dagger is insanely fast. I mean, as a dagger would be, but it's actually really nice. So now, there is something over here, and I am not going to... Yeah. I'm not gonna make it angry yet, but... We'll show what is over here. So, I don't know what the hell this thing is. But, oh man, there's an item over there, though, isn't there? I get the feeling if I come over here, it's gonna murder me. And in fact, it did once off camera. I shot it with my bow and did literally, like, 2 damage. So, I'm gonna leave that there for the moment. And we'll come back there. Maybe later I'll do it off camera. Or I will do a little extra recording and slap that in there. However, what I do want to do right now is make a quick jump cut and figure out what the hell's going on with this shield. Alright, so that is fixed. I'm not quite sure what it was. I might have accidentally put myself in some sort of guard stance, but if I did, I haven't the slightest idea how I did, so. But that seems to be all sorts of fixed now. Just double checking to make sure I got everything here. You're a dead dude. That is exceptionally pretty. Also, probably a good place to fall off. Hey, a bonfire. Oh, good, an achievement. Well, thank goodness. Now, it looks like I could get the jump on these guys, although I think this one might see me. Let's see if I take out this Joker first. Hey there. Oh no, you don't. No, missed my parry, but at least I can kind of get in there right away. However, what I do want to try is... not bad. Decent damage. Did lose a little health jumping down there. Fading Soul. Is there actually something down here? Or is this where I... oh my. No, we're not messing with it. Whoops, don't have those kind of arrows. Here we go. Gotcha. I'm already feeling pretty good about starting with the bow. Nice. Don't want to use all my arrows too soon, but a couple extra is not bad. We got a firebomb out of that. Nice. So my understanding is that the other flask is for MP, or whatever it's called. I think it's actually called FP. You are an angry fellow. I get a little bitter at my parrying though, because those missing those parries is gonna start to become a problem real fast. I get a lock on this guy. Gotcha. I actually didn't think I was in position to get that backstab, but it worked out anyway. Can I get this one too? Nope. But dagger is super, super fast. Takes like very little stamina. Oh, the jumping. Can I change that, actually? Where would that be? Whoops. Yeah, I might have to fiddle with that. I really dislike the control stick run. Or control stick jump, I should say. It was very unintuitive to me. In fact, I did just miss it. I don't think those guys can actually melee at all, which puts me at a huge advantage here. I do, however, want to go back up and grab whatever that item is. I don't know if it's important, but whatever it is, I want it. There we go. Titanite shard. Oh, nice. Yeah, I think I prefer the double tap on the jump, so fiddle around with that. So about all I know of the game is that this here is kind of a test. Question is, do I want to use my bow? Or do I want to just let this guy brutalize me? Yeah, never do that, by the way. Never take the huge sword out of the dude with the tentacles in his back. Tried to parry him here. Oh, man. Okay. So he's legit. Like, real legit. Alright, so he's got a big swing. Oh, wow. Okay. I'm actually gonna die out of this. That's gonna be sad, kind of embarrassing. How much damage does he take from arrows? A bit, but I don't think it's gonna be enough. Nope, nope, nope. Alright, it's fine. It's Dark Souls. I really want to know. I really want to parry him. I want to be careful about how many of those arrows I'm using, too. On the plus side, though, getting a little bit of extra souls here is not necessarily a bad thing. I'm not so good on that timing. I was gonna say, I thought there was a guy back here. Nope, that was a huge whiff. Oh man. Don't worry, if I die a lot, I'll make a cut. Again, I'm just trying to really get the handle on parrying here. Probably just go straight forward and just get it done. At least for this first bit. Instead of this embarrassing display. So what do I immediately do? Try to parry again. Yeah, I'm not quite too sure on the parry timing for that stab. I'm probably going a little too early. Come on, buddy. That one was just late. I have to do a lot of practice on that off camera, I think. Especially because I'm not going to have a good shield here. At least not for a long time. At least I got those souls back. Round two. Maybe don't try to parry him this time. Or maybe I'll try it once. Seems like you can't actually backstab him, though. Does turn very quickly. Oh, I lost my lock on there. Oh my, that looks unpleasant. Stamina. Oh no. There we go. Gotcha. Alright, yeah, when you're not trying to be fancy, it's actually really easy. I do kind of wish that I had been able to parry him, though. We got the coiled sword. We got our ember restored, so we're kind of all flamey now. I don't like the bonfire. Ember restoration, I'm assuming, is humanity. So I will, at least walk up through these doors, see what's up here. Good old Dark Souls doors. Boy, this area is just so pretty. Broken straight sword, probably not too useful. But menu, don't need to know that right now. How you guys doing? The other one doesn't seem to care at all. Oh. You gonna, like, walk right around? Oh, come on, you're not gonna walk by everybody here? I really kind of want him to just walk off the edge. I think that'd be pretty funny. Nope. All right, you have a long reach. Fine, let me parry you. Ooh. All right, so that's how you want to play, huh? Yeah, that's fine. We'll just, oh. Oh, no, you don't. Homeward Bone. Oh, handy. This reminds me of an area from Demon Souls. Boy, I can't remember the name of the place, but definitely really, really reminds me of walking up that hill in that first area. Oh my, that is a lot of enemies. There we go. Yay, okay. It's gonna get that timing down. Now this guy is gonna be kind of a problem. Relatively speaking. I mean, these are all very easy enemies. Ooh. You got very aggressive there. Yeah, this guy is really good at blocking. There we go. Alright, so now we got this Joker. Kinda wanna, yeah. Sneak on behind him. Now, the only other thing I know is that there's apparently a really dangerous enemy around this area that potentially has a good item. Oh, Jesus Christ. That legitimately just scared the hell out of me. Oh, Dark Souls. Oh, no, whoa, 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 whoa. No, no, no. Ah, missed my parry there. Man, I'm really gonna have to practice that a bit off camera and get that timing down. Warrior of War, then try counterattack. I wonder if hello, friend. Are you dumb enough to fall into this pit? The answer to that is no. You are smart enough to kill me, though. He does not look like he is very healthy. I bet I can kill him with arrows, though. Fortunately, it seems like when you're in that animation, you get invincibility. Which is good. These guys with the spears are really kind of my kryptonite right now, though. I thought I could slide on by. Oh, friend. Yep, I was gonna do this to you. Oh, you actually blocked that. So where are those two ambushers? Because I don't want to... Oh, there they are. Okay, I see them now. Ooh, actually missed him there. Oh, wow! I'm stunned. I really did not think he would hit that hard. Alright, well, let me get back there and I'll return in a moment. So here we are. And if you look at my soul count, minus 2,000, you can probably take a guess at how many times I've been through this area. Now also this shield came from the tree back here. I picked that up along the way. So I was actually feeling pretty good about this. I'm like, oh man, I'm getting really good at parrying. More or less. I'm starting to parry this guy, and then I died. I had him, like, really low. And so I'm like, oh, man, maybe I'll just, like, I'll record the next attempt, right? Dude fell off the cliff. And, yeah. So, free stuff. Hooray! Uchigatana, nice. Master Tower, Master Glove. Yeah, so I knew there was a good item up here, but I didn't know what it was. So that is pretty sweet. Let's see what our armor looks like here. Seems to be not very good. Sure, it looks pretty weird on a lady as well, yeah. I did drop gloves though, right? Yeah. Alright, so we'll definitely wear those. And what does the Uchigatana look like here? How much does it require, rather? Requires 16 dexterity, 11 strength. So we can probably get that pretty soon, especially since I have a bunch of extra souls. So I'm just going to wander up over here to the next major area. And then I will pause for now. We'll continue next time. An ember, nice. Obviously, I lost mine. Or I lost my humanity, rather. Or whatever we want to call it nowadays. And I actually don't know where I'm going. It is always scary. Homeward Bone. There must be an entrance around here somewhere. Another ember. Wow, okay. Also, apologies for the wild camp. Oh, what are you? Oh, God. All right, I don't know what you were, but you're dead. That's like a skeleton dog? Of some sorts. So what was the path I was taking? Yeah, here we go. Visions of good luck. Ah, Firelink Shrine. Let there be comfort. I'm assuming you are gonna let me level up? Are you the lady from Demon Souls? No, you're just trying to be.
Welcome to the bonfire, unkindled one. I am a firekeeper. I tend to the flame and tend to thee. The lords have left their thrones and must be delivered to them. To this end, I am at thy side.
Hmm.
Ashen one. To be unkindled is to be a vessel for souls. Sovereignless souls will become thy strength. I will show thee how. Ashen One, bring me souls plucked from their vessels.
Very well. All right, let's level up.
Then touch the darkness within me.
Oh, that's a nice little callback.
Nourishment from these sovereignless souls.
Okay, so, is... Vigor. Alright, Vigor is HP. Wait, Vitality is not HP? Okay, maximum equip load. Endurance is Stamina. Boy, that would have been a, kind of an embarrassing thing there. So we need a bunch of dexterity and a couple of strength. So that lets me use the Uchigatana, I believe. And then, so vigor is health, vitality is equip load, endurance is stamina. Again, if you're gonna get salty at me spending points, I would recommend immediately not worrying so much about it, because I'm probably going to spend points in a supremely unoptimal fashion, suboptimal fashion. That actually perfectly uses all of my souls. Yeah, all right. Yeah, that's good enough. And now I should be able to equip the good old Uchi. Yes, I get you, lady. There we go. Much better. All right, well, that'll do for now. So thank you for watching. you like the video, click like. Helps me a lot. Let you know how you like this sort of thing. If you like this sort of thing, subscribe if you want to see more, and I will see you soon.